I am Advocate H.M. Suthar, based in Goregaon, Mumbai. And I am an advocate dealing with the cooperative society matters only, primarily. Today I intend to deal with the topic of associate member, and the issues which I cover are admission of associate members, their resignations, their cessation of the membership, their rights and interest, their right to participate in the election of the committees under the new amended law. To start with, friends, before I go to the topic per se, let me tell you that there are huge number of disputes and differences coming forward in the Office of Deputy Registrars from the society and its members in the context of membership of the society by the associate member and their participation in the election process if the associate member does not have interest in the property, that is a flat. This is aggravated by the fact that the social media is very active and the messages are sent through the social media which are like wildfire. And therefore, I believe today's topic is extremely important to set right the confusions, disputes and differences. Firstly, I will deal with admission. Primarily, there are two types of associate memberships. One is a joint owner of the property and another is admission of associate member, which is the decision of the owner of the flat, and such associate member can become a member of the society by an application under the prescribed form by paying 100 rupees entrance fees. Let me tell you that the membership, which is we call it a primary member and the associate member, there are nominal members also, there are sympathizer members also, but the definition of associate member is as given in the Act and the bylaws is a person whose name does not stand first in the share certificate issued by the society is an associate member. The rights, particularly the rights relating to participation in the election and attending the general body meeting, are dealt with by various provisions including section 27. Having completed the admission by way of application for membership at the joint owner of the property or otherwise by paying 100 rupees stamp entrance fees, a member will cease to be associate member under various circumstances. The one is on the death of primary member, an associate member will cease to be the member of the society if and only if he does not have interest in the property. This particular amendment has been made in the bylaws, in the recent 2014 bylaws. Otherwise, there was no such provision. And therefore, on the death of the primary member, on the death of the associate member, on disqualification of associate member, and on resignation of the associate member, on acceptance of the resignation by the committee, the member will cease to be associate member. This is so far as the cessation of the membership of associate member is concerned. Coming back to a very important aspect, is it possible for the primary member to throw away the associate member? Let me tell you, as far as the associate member has the interest in the property, that is the flat, the primary member cannot throw away the associate member. It is possible to get out the associate member only and only when the associate member does not have interest in the property. The dispute, because of, as I told you initially, that because of the social media, the societies, the committees, the members of the societies have approached the respective registrars complaining that the associate member has become the committee member or the chairman or the secretary of the society. And they have been pleading that the associate member does not have a right. This particular aspect is a misguidance in view of the fact that as per the Act and the rules and the bylaws, there is no provision that an associate member need to have an interest in the property to enable such member to participate in the election. Why this issue has been raised and why this controversy? Friends, let me tell you, this controversy has resulted because of the guidelines issued by the government of Maharashtra under Section 79A of the Maharashtra Cooperative Societies Act by way of direction, which was published by the Commissioner of Cooperation, the Registrar of Societies, in the form of Housing Societies Manual. Even though there was no provision in the Act and the rules and the bylaws to the effect that the associate member without interest in the property cannot participate in the election, the manual came out with a particular paragraph where it was mentioned, directed by the state government, that associate member who does not have interest in the property is not eligible to contest the election or participate in the election. This policy, or we can say the discrepancy, was noticed by the registrar, the Commissioner of Cooperation, and it was brought to the notice of the state government, and a request was made to the state government to allow the registrar to delete that particular paragraph. The government, having interpreted and understood the nature of the direction given, which was against the provisions of the law, gave permission to the registrar to delete that particular paragraph. These guidelines were issued sometime on 15th October 2011. As of today, it has been amended. That particular paragraph has been deleted out of the housing manual and the legal position is restored. Friend, let me tell you, even with that direction, the law never disqualified the associate member, and therefore associate member was always eligible to participate in the election. So the final position as of today is to put the dispute to the rest, that the associate member can participate in the election even though they do not have the interest in the property. Friends, if you want any further clarifications in this issue, you may feel free to contact my office on the given email ID by question. You can visit my website and also put a question to me. Thanks, friends.